Hey, Crystal lovers, Ashley Levy here with the Love and Light School of Crystal Therapy, and today I'm going to be talking a little bit about crystals for the elements. But first, let's talk about why this is even important. Why would you ever need to know which element a crystal connects with? Well, the answer actually comes down to astrology. This is one of the best ways that you can use crystals to connect with your zodiac or astrological sign. So, for example, I am a Sagittarius. I'm a fire sign, have fiery energy. If I wanted to enhance the really positive qualities and aspects of Sagittarius, then I'd work with a fire element stone. Or if I wanted to balance out some of those not so great fiery aspects of Sagittarius, I would work with the opposite element, which in this case would be water. So fire and water are opposites, and earth and air are opposites. So if you are an earth sign and you want to enhance your earth-like qualities, maybe you're a Taurus, then you would work with something in the earth category of crystals, or to enhance those qualities. But if you really wanted to balance out some of the negative aspects of that, then you'd work with an air crystal. So that's just a really simple understanding of why you might need to know this information. So let's dig into some of my favorite crystals for each element. I'm going to give you three of my favorites for each of the four elements. So let's start with earth. This is a stone that's kind of a newer find. It's called Cosmic Jasper, and it comes from Madagascar. It's so beautiful, and even though it has a swirly kind of nebulous cosmic vibe to it, it's still so earthy. It's so strongly connected with earth energy, and you just feel more connected to nature and to your crystals and to your physical body when you work with this stone. So Cosmic Jasper, totally gorgeous stuff. My next earth element is one that hopefully all of you have in your crystal healing toolkits, and that is smoky quartz. So here's a cute little smoky quartz point, one of my little faves. It's just like a great little pocket piece. This stone helps keep you grounded and shielded, so it's an excellent earth energy stone. Then, last but not least, there is unakite. Now, I always think of unakite as having a lot of goddess energy. So this is a rock that's composed of green epidote and peach feldspar kind of combined together. So it's bringing in this kind of balance of earth energy with a hint of divine feminine, and it really strongly relates to the goddess Gaia. So this is an excellent earth energy stone. Next, let's move to air, and I have three crystals that I really love using with air. One of them is a little less common. It's purple jade. There's something that's just so celestial and cloud-like about looking at this stone. So purple jade is an excellent air element stone, promotes a lot of mental clarity and helps connect with the air element that way. Then there's angel aura quartz. So this is quartz that has a platinum coating on the outside and gives off this really celestial angelic vibe. And when we think of turning to the heavens for advice and guidance, we think of angel aura quartz. So really strongly related to the air element. Last but not least, of course, clear quartz. This is such an amazing air element stone. It can also be used for the fire element because it's so intense and amplifying. It has a lot of energy to it. But when you get a really beautifully clear piece of quartz like this, it's a great stone for connecting and tuning into the air element, providing a lot of mental clarity and some guidance on your path. Next, we have fire. One of my favorites for this is hematoid quartz. So this is quartz that's from Madagascar, and it has inclusions of hematite. So really kind of grounding, but in a way that's motivating, that incites passion. So this is an excellent fire element stone. Then we have red jasper. Red jasper is another good one to really get you going, get you motivated about something, but it also helps you kind of balance that inner drive and direct it in a super focused way. So you actually accomplish things instead of just spinning your wheels. And then one of my favorite fire element stones is fire opal. And here is some fire opal from Mexico. You can see it's just kind of all throughout this matrix or host rock here. And this is like the ultimate fire energy stone. It's like you can just feel the heat of this, the energy of this trapped in this crystal. And I love working with this for a little boost of fire element energy. Then finally, we have the water element. So one stone I really love working with for the water element is Peruvian blue opal. Now this is pretty cool, and this comes from the Andes Mountains, and this is a really, really large piece, and there's a little bit of matrix around it. But I love this not only because of the color, it's beautiful blue and its connection to water that way, but also because opal actually contains extra water molecules in it. So there's actually some water right there in the stone. Then there's a stone that many of you have probably started to see around lately called garnierite, and it has this beautiful sheen that reminds me of the shimmer of sunlight off of the surface of the ocean. And I love connecting with this for enhancing your intuition, which is one of the things that the water element is known for. And then finally, beautiful, gorgeous Larimar has such a strong connection to the water element, not only because it's found on an island in the ocean, but it's also known as the dolphin stone. It's a great stone for communication, and it just kind of allows for this free flow of words. And so when we want to just kind of ease into something, go with the flow, tune into that water element, Larimar makes a great crystal companion. So those are my three favorite crystals for connecting with each of the elements. I hope that you found a lot of useful info in today's video. Thanks so much for watching. I'm Ashley Levy of the Love and Light School of Crystal Therapy and Crystal Blessings.